Hey guys, here we are in the Spec Racer Fords at VIR for a 40-minute race. Now this was a super fun race. We had like a 40-car field. I'm actually going to show you what the start of the race looked like, and then I'm going to play the rest of the race from my onboard view, which was just incredible. We were starting in 19th place, so we're right in the middle of the field, and it was filled with chaos, a lot of slipstream, and a pretty exciting finish. So hope you enjoy, and see you at the end. So that was the whole field going by the finish line, and now I'm gonna ride on board with my onboard for the rest of the race. So we just managed to hang on to 15th place at the end there, with a lot of damage due to that last lap incident, which I'm going to review in just a minute here. But you can see coming to the line, 16th place, just didn't have the time to catch us, and we managed to beat him by 2 tenths of a second, as we can see here, 2 tenths, and then 4 tenths to the car behind here. So yeah, unfortunate that we ended up losing those spots. But let's look at that last lap incident. So right at this point, starting the final lap, we're in 11th place, and we're looking for 10th place here. And the thing that I see, I'm expecting him to be aggressive in terms of defensiveness, and so I go to make my move here, and I see a car length here. And as I go over there, there is like a car length, and then it's like half a car length, and I'm waiting for him to give me room, and now there's just about a car length here. So I feel like he kind of pushed me onto the grass. It is debatable, but it's like kind of the way the track kind of shaped, the way that the kind of pushed me onto the grass a bit. I don't know, it was debatable. And then I'm just trying to break in a straight line, and I don't know if I lock up the tires or whatnot, but just the fact that I need to make the corner, so I need to put the wheel, need to turn at some point. When I turn, there's just no grip at all out there, which causes me to spin. So really unfortunate. I mean, I felt like I was able to make the corner. I wasn't gonna hit anyone here. I wasn't braking super late. Managed to avoid any contact and just didn't expect the rear to slide out. So ended up hitting that guy. But luckily, the guy that ended up hitting me, he managed to. I didn't ruin his race completely, since if we just go back and watch his onboard, here he is as he goes into the corner. He gets collected, but he's the guy that ends up passing me later in the lap. So he ends up passing me through this left-hander here. So he ends up finishing a 13th. He may have gotten a few more spots, but I ended up losing arguably 4 or 5 spots, because if I could have made that pass, I would have gotten 10th instead of get 15th. But at least I'm able to finish the race, and I don't actually get a meatball from this. It's just a lot of optional. But even if I got a meatball, I was able to at least drive it around that final lap. But I want to show one more thing, which was on lap 17 when we were going 3 wide. This is probably like one of the most exciting parts of the race. I saw this. We were just trying to stay in this draft train. The car behind had some nice slipstream. Once again, this car kind of leaving a car length over here, but pinching me a bit as well, being a bit aggressive. And I get on the brakes, not wanting to overshoot the corner, and goes from 3 wide to 2 wide, and somehow this guy manages to get by me. So yeah, I'd see that from like a far chase view. Yeah, it's hard enough to make it through there 2 wide, let alone 3 wide. So I'm glad we're all able to make it out there alive and keep it clean. But yeah, just super fun racing. And now let's actually check out the battle for the win here. So we skip to the final lap. It's Lynn and Panero, and it looks like then there's a pretty big gap to third place. So there's like a 3-car battle or so for third. But first place was just a 2-car battle, and as we went down the final straight, there was a move for the lead. Marco was able to get past Lynn, but let's see what happened coming to the finish line. Well, I thought Lynn might have a chance to be able to go for the win. He was within slipstream range, but just ran out of fuel coming out of the final corner. So let's see. Did third place close up on him at all? Looks like they were so far. Oh, maybe third ran out of fuel too? Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah, it's accelerating, and well, maybe not. I think he was good on fuel, but yeah, they were so far back that they didn't catch Lynn. So Congrats to Panero and Lynn for somehow managing a podium even after running out of fuel. And we managed to get 15th. And how many guys finished on the lead lap? Looks like 38 guys. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and see you next time.